General Atomics has announced that it had successfully flight-tested a dispenser pod for the MQ-9B SeaGuardian drone. It's part of a larger plan to enhance the anti-submarine warfare capabilities of the platform. As per reports, in this particular test, the pods were used to release sonobuoys. Sonobuoys are basically expendable sonar systems that could be used to detect submarines. The company also stated that the dispenser pod will also be able to launch precision-guided munitions as well as small drones. The anti-submarine warfare test took place last November and was conducted in cooperation with the U.S. Navy. The experiment involved flying the drone in U.S. Navy's test ranges off the coast of Southern California and transmitting data to a ground operations center of the U.S. Army's Yuma Proving Ground in Arizona. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how MQ-9B SeaGuardian drone will take on Russian and Chinese submarines. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles, from the 1930s to the 1990s, and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Russia has worked to enhance its naval capabilities since 2000. The latest variant of the Russian Kilo-class submarine represents a significant evolution. It was demonstrated in 2017 when, out of the blue, a series of cruise missiles tore through the air toward targets around Syria's besieged city of Palmyra. They came from the Kilo-class submarine Krasnodar, which remained undetected before the missile launch. Krasnodar was dubbed as Black Hole by some analysts. The Russians are also building two other new designs, Boreai-class ballistic missile submarines, which will be the cornerstone and most survivable part of its nuclear arsenal, and the Hunter-Killer Yasin-class, intended to destroy U.S. aircraft carriers. Importantly, the activities of the Russian submarine fleet have increased several folds in the last few years. The Chinese military has seen a lot of investments in the last two decades, and its People's Liberation Army Navy, or PLAN, has got a significant portion of it. PLAN has a fleet of conventionally powered as well as nuclear-powered submarines. There are about three nuclear-powered attack submarines of Type 091 Han class and six of Type 093 Shang class in active service. The conventionally powered submarines consist of 17 Yuan class, 9 Russian origin Kilo class, 13 Song class, and 15 Ming class. Also, new submarines are being constantly constructed. China's policy has meant that it's now using this fleet in a more aggressive manner. During the test, the MQ-9A, which was used in the place of MQ-9B, deployed 10 sonobuoys in total. These included 1 ANSSQ-36B, 2 ANSSQ-62F Directional Command Activated Sonobuoy Systems, DICAS, and 7 ANSSQ-53G Directional Frequency Analysis and Recording, DIFAR, buoys. The ANSSQ-36B can detect underwater objects by changes in water temperature. The DICAS is equipped with active sonar, whereas DIFAR can passively gather acoustic data. Technically, the deployed sonobuoys have a significant capability and could potentially uncover enemy submarines lurking in the depths of the oceans. General Atomics ASI President David R. Alexander said, "This demonstration is a first for airborne ASW. The successful completion of this testing paves the way for the future development of more anti-submarine warfare capabilities from our MQ-9s. P-8 is the premier anti-submarine warfare ASW platform of the U.S. Navy. Apart from ASW, it's capable of anti-surface warfare (ASUW) and shipping interdiction. The P-8 Poseidon is developed by Boeing and is modified from the 737-800ERX. Powered by two CFM56 7B27A engines, it's able to reach a maximum speed of 490 knots or 907 kilometers per hour, and has a combat radius of 1,380 miles or 2,222 kilometers that enables it to cover large swaths of ocean. The P-8 is equipped with radar, optical, and sonar sensors to detect submarines and surface ships. P-8 has 5 internal and 6 external stations for weapons and currently deploy AGM 84HK Slammer, AGM 84 Harpoons, Mark 54 Torpedo, unguided missiles, mines, and SMART as well as freefall bombs. P-8A is the American variant, and the U.S. has received delivery of more than 90 of these, with approximately an additional 30 on order. With the increasing threat of Russian and Chinese submarines, the workload on P-8A is bound to increase. The General Atomics MQ-9 Reaper, sometimes called Predator B, is an unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV, capable of remotely controlled or autonomous flight operations. The MQ-9 is the first hunter-killer UAV designed for long endurance, high altitude surveillance. Reaper's main sensor is the nose-mounted MTSB multispectral surveillance and targeting turret, and its fuselage-mounted Lynx synthetic aperture radar. But the Reaper's pylons are very versatile and can be used to carry a variety of tactical equipment like communications relay hops, electronic warfare pods, as well as wide area aerial surveillance WAAS camera arrays. The additional sensors are designed to act in conjunction with the drone's main sensors. A navalized Reaper was proposed for the U.S. Navy's Broad Area Maritime Surveillance BAMS program. General Atomics continued with the Naval Reaper concept, turning it into the SeaGuardian. It has an endurance of more than 18 hours and can mount an 8-hour patrol at a radius of 1,400 miles or 2,200 kilometers. A key part of its mission set is the Leonardo Sea Spray 7500E V2 AESA radar, mounted as a centerline pod with inverse synthetic aperture radar that can spot surface targets, including ships, submarine periscopes, and people during search and rescue operations. MQ-9B SeaGuardian, equipped with sonobuoys, will go a long way in easing the burden on P-8As, which are manned aircraft. The platform will also be much more cost-effective, as the cost per hour of flight is significantly less. As of now, it's unclear the exact types of munitions and small drones General Atomics plans to integrate with the MQ-9B SeaGuardian drone through the dispenser pod. But since the dispenser pod is compatible with the Common Launch Tube (CLT), it opens up a lot of possibilities. When it comes to munitions, Dynetics GBU-69B Small Glide Munition (SGM) could be used. As for small drones, Raytheon's Coyote is one of the options. MQ-9B SeaGuardian could evolve into a platform that can detect and even take out enemy submarines And this has massive ramifications when it comes to boasting American anti-submarine warfare capability. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.